Echo Monkeys, James Bush here with M. Gymkhana back in the U.S. of A. Welcome back to the next episode of Cone Monkey TV. So sorry to have missed you in Barcelona. It looked as though the trip was fantastic. There was lots of stuff going on. Usually around that March time in Barcelona, the last couple of days of F1 testing in Barcelona. It was great to see. I remember doing that last year as well. But again, seeing everyone there at the Honda facility for those 2 or 3 days is fantastic. The dinners, I missed out on all the good food, all the good conversation, all the good wine. So again, hopefully we'll remedy that for next year. Perhaps this year in July, we'll be in France. Perhaps in October, November in Japan. So we'll see what happens. But let's get caught up on what's going on with the Cone Monkey Nation. So here's what's taking place in the WC1 results. The 2019 M. Gymkhana WC competition has kicked off. And again, last month there was 43 participants. Generally speaking, it's a little bit more challenging to participate in the first couple rounds of competition in Europe. The weather can be challenging sometimes, but again, 43 of you guys were able to submit a time. Fantastic to see. Of those 43, there were 9 female Cone Monkey entries. Awesome. I think 9 has been our most. 9 female Cone Monkey entries. One of those female Cone Monkey entries got 1 point. Marie Girlings, thank you so much for your participation. You were able to get a point out of, again, 43 participants. It's great to see. But again, 9 female Cone Monkeys, Marie, Anoko, and Lunica, you've got some competition this year. We'll see how the rest of it goes. But again, thank you so much. The kickoff of the 2019 M. Gymkhana season has already begun. Round 1 is done and dusted. Round 2, hope you guys are enjoying so far. Again, as we go on, the rounds are going to get a little bit more challenging, a little bit more technical, and I hope you guys enjoy this round like you have been the past couple rounds, the past couple years of the WC competition. Again, I want to thank everyone so much for all of your participation, of being able to submit a time, being able to see where you stack up against other riders all over the globe. Is great to see the number of riders, the different levels of riding, the different countries. Now, we have 9 females participating. We've got men participating, which is also awesome. But we've got our youngest participant, and we'll show you what she did right here. I'm only kidding. This is Jan crashing. But the 9-year-old girl is from Czech Republic. She's named Bea, and she rides a TTR 110, and you'll see her next month. So as I'm sure you did not see me in Barcelona this last weekend, I was not able to attend. Again, very, very sad about that. Would have been great to see Arnold and Helen and Martin and Marie and everyone. But I've got a couple videos that were sent to me by Jeroen, who's made some really cool slow-mo videos, as well as some pictures and some of the results that happened in this past weekend. So take a peek. can see, Co Monkeys, I was not in Spain. I'm sure you all missed me. I missed you guys just as much. Helen and Arnold missed you guys a ton. Martine, Marie, everyone missed you guys. But Nobel, you probably saw a really cool NSR 250. This is Bert Scholl's motorcycle. The NSR 250, I believe it's an MC2 type. MC21 type, sorry about that. This is my VTR. All of our motorcycles are always in some type of repair or change or alteration or whatever the case may be. As you can see, this one's being worked on. I've got to put some throttle cables in, some stuff like that as well. But again, always doing something to it, always working on it in some way, shape, or form. But this is what happens. But our motorcycles are kind of our babies. But this is Bert Scholl's baby. And what I'm going to be doing, what we're going to be doing on Comlinky TV, is we're going to be introducing you to different riders and their motorcycles, just kind of giving you an idea and a flavor of the variety of things that take place and the variety of motorcycles that participate in Moto Gymkhana, so you don't feel like, can this bike work? Does this bike work? So forth. But the NSR 250 is one of those classic Moto Gymkhana motorcycles that have been working forever. And again, this is Bert Scholl's motorcycle. We'll introduce you to Bert and his bike. Bert Scholl lives in a place called Harlem. Now, this is not one of the five boroughs in New York, Bronx, Brooklyn, and so forth. This is a Harlem. This is a place near the Amsterdam, about 30 minutes outside of Amsterdam, from what I understand. He competes for Team NL, or not the Netherlands, and he's been interested in the sport since 2012. Bert started riding Moto Gymkhana on a K1200 RS, so significantly different than what he ended up riding right now. His first season, he competed on a CB1, kind of like Tweety Bird that Marie Gerlings competes on. His second season in 2016, he competed on that same CB1, and in 2017, he picked up the NSR. Now, the NSR, kind of a cool story. It's a pike, obviously, we know it from Japan. The problem is that they don't really sell outside of Japan too often, but he was able to find one in the UK, so he took a trip there at the end of 2016, rode the bike, liked it a lot, and bought it. Because of that, he wanted to import it to the Netherlands, but it took a little bit of planning, and it took some time. Eventually, in the winter of 2016 and 17, he had a few weeks to convert the bike to a street version, and he bought it basically Gymkhana ready. Because it also took a few months to get used to the bike, he knew he wouldn't be that competitive in his first season, but he went for it anyway. From there, he basically got some clip-ons, some super bike handlebars, crash cage, changed the sprockets front and rear, removed the fairings and a few other bits and bobs. Over the winter in 2018, he knew that he wanted to change even more. The main drivetrain, the weight reduction that he wanted to get rid of. He lost a total of about 17 kilos on the bike with some of the changes that he made. He swapped the rear end subframe from a steel one to an aluminum one, and you can see the sexy look of that thing right now. He took off an oil injection and changed the premix on the NXR. He took off the battery. He didn't need it anymore. That saved a lot of weight as well, and a few other things. So this is what you have now. Started out this way, ends up this way. Thanks so much, Bert Scholl. We appreciate all of the pictures that you sent in and a little bit of the information and background on you. Get your cone on. So that does it for us, Cone Monkeys. We will see you next episode. Again, if you're not already riding on it, get out and get your cone on the 2019 MGM Kind of WC Round 2. It's a fun course. As normal, the courses will be getting more and more technical and more challenging as the year goes on. We will be dropping your lowest score. Don't forget to click that button and subscribe to Cone Monkey TV. A lot of you are still on the regular MGM kind of channel on YouTube, but switch over to the Cone Monkey TV channel or subscribe to both, because we're actually doing a lot more stuff, or we will be doing more stuff on Cone Monkey TV than the previous channel. So subscribe to Cone Monkey TV as soon as you get off done with this video. We will be in San Diego March 23rd. So we'll see you guys then, and then back at Auto Club Speedway in April. So we'll see you next time, Cone Monkeys. Get your cone on.